everybody. As she said, my name is Adam, and I'm going to be talking about human trafficking and just kind of how God is to that and how we can see that more of it. So I think when it comes to human trafficking, a lot of people kind of get it confused, whether that's with prostitution or with smuggling people across borders. And while prostitution is part of it, smuggling people is kind of something different. Human trafficking more focuses on the recruitment and transportation of people, and it's always against their will. The concept of consent in this doesn't come to play. The people who are being trafficked, they don't have a say in what happens. They don't have a say in where they're taken, what they have to do, how they're treated. And so as you can see here, the majority of it is sex trafficking, but there's also other types such as labor, and as you can see, there's others. These include organ trafficking, and also things like forcing children into service in the military in different countries. So a lot of time it's done through either threat or force, or tricking the people into situations like these. A lot of times, things like threat will include threatening their family members, or threatening their personal safety, or financial wise. Also, using debts, if the people feel like they're indebted to the people, to their captors, they'll come with them and do whatever it is they ask. And it's a really fast-growing industry. And all the stats that I have up here are also written up back there, so you can see. So when it comes to the victims, the majority of the time they are young people. As you can see, ages from 13 to 21. There are cases, however, even younger. Sometimes children who are forced into prostitution can be as young as 11 years old, which is just absolutely disgusting. And a lot of the time the people that recruit these victims, the majority are male, but you also see a lot of female people recruiting, especially with the girls, because they connect with them personally, and then once they have them in their, whatever it is they're doing, whether that's labor or sex trafficking, they just turn on them and are incredibly cool to them. And so what these people will do is they will prey on people who are weak, as you can see there in the bottom left, whether that's homeless, runaways, displaced homemakers, which a homemaker is somebody who takes care of the house, that takes care of duties in the house, whether female or female. And then if that house ends up falling apart, they don't have a job, so they're looking for a job. As you can see, debtors, drug addicts, kidnapping victims, or refugees, a lot of time will be taken advantage because of their vulnerable situation. They go to these people and they look for help in places that they shouldn't be looking, or they don't know they shouldn't be looking, and then those people use those situations to take them into modern-day slavery. So this is specifically focusing on the sexual aspect of it because it is the majority of that. There's a difference between prostitution and sexual exploitation. A lot of the times, the prostitution, as you can see, is started because girls are running away from their homes, they get displaced as refugees or things like that, and then they're taken advantage of. With sexual exploitation, however, it comes down to often children being sold into this type of slavery by their parents or their guardians. And you can see it's an incredibly lucrative business. There have been reports of even cartels switching from selling drugs to solely focusing on human trafficking because it's a more lucrative business in that sense. You see there, two children are trafficked every minute across the world. And just the fact that these children, who we think are so safe, are actually vulnerable to this type of modern day slavery, because that's what this is. A lot of times also we think of this happening outside of our country, in countries who are less fortunate than us. And what we actually are seeing is that it's more and more happening in the United States, more so than other countries, because it is so much easier for those the traffickers to find children in these countries instead of taking them across borders, because the mental laws, all the different laws that there are. But more and more we see children in our own backyards, own neighborhoods being taken away and forced into sex trafficking, slavery, labor trafficking, having the organs taken from them. Anything that these people can use those children's bodies, and not just children, but young people as well. Anything you can use their actual body for is what they're doing, and just using them as victims of human trafficking. So obviously, there's a lot of evil to this, a lot of cruelty to this, but I think it's also important to consider how can we as Christians step into this terrible world and terrible just atmosphere, and how can we play a role in this system in helping us out. So I have some questions for you guys to lament about when we get to that point, and also just to read some stories about actual victims and what they've been through, and then about how they're so.
Can you do us a favor? Can you
go
back to the first slide and then spend like maybe
30
seconds so people can
read? Oh, yeah, sure. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask. If I don't know if there are questions, then just put the information. Yeah, go.
It's here for me.
Okay, yeah, so basically, the way, so there's a system that we use to rank different countries in how they rank on a scale. So tier one will be, this country has laws set in place, they're doing their best to follow laws, enforce the laws, everything they can do to stop it. Even if it's still resistant, at least they're making an effort. Mm-hmm. And then you jump out of tier two, where this country doesn't have laws, but they're kind of trying to make an effort. And then you get to tier three, where there are no laws in place, or the country is not making an effort at all, and it's just running rampant. But there is, take that with a grain of salt, because the country that ranks these countries is the United States. So if we're ranking ourselves as a tier one, how the time is that? Any other questions?
Can you explain the different, a little bit more about sex trafficking, labor trafficking, and organ trafficking? So how those different spheres of trafficking
are? Okay, so with sex trafficking, that really oftentimes comes down to what we think as prostitution. I think a lot of Americans has prostitution in their minds as something that, oh, those girls are doing that because they want to do that or they think it's fun. But actually what's happening is they're being controlled by a pimp who, which is not a good term at all. I think in our culture we think a pimp is also somebody who has money and they're cool and all this stuff. But in reality, this pimp is beating the girls, forcing these girls to have sex with up to 50 men per day. Putting them out on the street from 6 in the afternoon until 6 in the morning. And these girls, they don't get to keep any of the money. The only thing these girls get from doing this is shelter and food. And then the pimps will buy things for them once in a while to make them feel like they're welcome when they're actually just using them for sex. So that's kind of what the whole sex trafficking aspect is. Labor trafficking, a lot of the times we see that with agricultural labor, especially with temporary visas that we see people coming into our country. With these temporary visas, a lot of times they aren't taken care of by anybody who lets them into the country. The government is keeping track of what happens to them. So these farmers that are using these temporary visas will treat the people coming in terribly, don't pay them at all, barely ever feeds them, and they threaten them with deportation so they can't go to the authorities, they can't get any of the help for the rights they deserve. And they're kind of just stuck in this trap of labor trafficking in that sense. And finally, with organ trafficking, there's two different types. There's whether it's organ trafficking, kidnapping somebody to steal organs from them, or using people who are willingly giving up their organs to get money for them, basically selling the organs off to people who want to skip the line. And because there is such a demand for organs nowadays, people want to pay more money to get the organs, and so they're basically taking advantage of these people who are less fortunate and willing to sell parts of their bodies to them just to live a couple more years, which in most cases the organs they receive don't work anyway. Sorry, I don't know how much time I have.
No, you're good. You have like 3 points.
Okay.
Does sex trafficking also include child pornography and horrifying sex trafficking?
Yeah, so another thing is that includes sex trafficking is selling online sex. So that includes through websites like Craigslist or the big one that a lot of people know about is Backpage, where there's a big Supreme Court case with that about how a website is responsible for what's put on their website. Mm-hmm. And so yeah, it does include child pornography. A lot of the times the girls that are used as prostitutes are eventually fed into that market because the pimps see that as the next pathway to go once they start losing money from their business. Anything that includes that aspect of sexual exploitation or prostitution is included in that sphere of sexual. Yeah, so it has to do with the CDA.
Communications
Agency Act. Yeah, Communications Agency Act. So what they did is they created an amendment to it saying that if the website is facilitating this facilitation of illegal activity, whether that be sex trafficking or drug trading, then they can be found liable.
Okay.
Instead of just saying anything that happens on there isn't responsible for.
Okay.
Yeah. And as I said, everything on these three slides will be on that. I'm sorry, some of the bad quality that I have to do. It'll be.